normal for the 4A state championship matchup in girls high school volleyball as the Minooka Indians take on the Mighty Macs from Mother McAuley. Along with Laura Donbors, I'm Scott Slocum. You coached and played here, but whenever Mother McAuley comes to Normal, it's a special night because they've won 14 state titles. Minooka has never won one at all.
No, but it'll be a great matchup because both of these teams combined have six Division I recruits.
Yeah, a lot of talented players, no doubt about that. Well, let's break them down. Let's start with Mother McAuley, the young lady that's headed to Notre Dame, Charlene Ego.
Charlie, she is an impressive athlete, dominant on the outside. Expect Minooka to try and find a solution for her.
Minooka's big three junior frontliners all have Division I rides already, but tonight let's focus on Rocky Perenar.
Rocky, another great outside hitter. So tonight it is the balance of the outsides. Rocky's got great shots and, again, a very dominant arm.
All right, the keys to this game here tonight, I think first of all for Mother McAuley, is to not take Minooka for granted.
Absolutely, and both of these teams having such high offense, it's going to be important that their defense steps up tonight.
And Minooka, conversely, they look across and see the Mighty Macs. They can't get intimidated or they'll be in trouble.
No, it's point by point for both of these teams, and we expect a high caliber, fast-paced game.
All right, Coach, buckle up. This one's going to be fun. It's the 4A state championship from Redbird Arena. It's the Mighty Macs and the Indians next on Comcast Sportsnet.
The IHSA is achievement. Focus. Creativity. Spirit. Champions. The future plays here. The Illinois High School Association.
Country Financial wants to know, what do you look for in a financial services partner?
Get to know us and get to know what we need and what we want to do.
Treat me like they would treat their family.
Help us decide what is a want and what is a need.
I want something tailor-made for me.
At Country Financial, our goal is to take the time to get to know you and then help you put together a customized package of insurance and financial solutions to help you own your future.
When someone really listens and they're planning for us, I trust them.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
Class 4A championship match between Minooka High School and Mother McAuley High School of Chicago. First, let's meet the coaches. For the home team, the Indians of Minooka High School. They enter the match with a record of 35 wins and 6 losses. Please meet Coach Emily Soto, who has a record of 63 wins, 17 losses in her 2-year career. For the visiting team, the Mighty Macs of Mother McAuley High School, who enter the match with a record of 39 wins and 1 loss. Please meet Coach Jen Gerald. Coach Gerald has a record of 419 wins and 67 losses in her 12-year career. And now, let's meet our starting lineups. First, for the Indians, a 5'6 junior, number 2, Taylor Baranski. For Mother McAuley, of 6-foot junior, number 5, Charlie Nego. For Minooka, a 5'10 senior, number 3, Brooklyn Bachman. From Mother McAuley, a 5'9 senior, number 6, Abby O'Brien. For the Indians of Minooka, a 6'1" junior, number 5, Allie Pepish. For the Mighty Macs, a 6-foot senior, number 8, Katie O'Connell. For the Indians, a 6-foot junior, wearing number 8, Rocky Perenar. For Mother McAuley, a 5'11 senior, number 10, Mary Kate Boland. Minooka, a 5'9 junior, number 9, Olivia Clank. For the Mighty Max, a 6-foot junior, number 12, Amanda Horn. For the Indians, a 6-foot, 2-inch junior, number 11, Holly Bonte. For the Mighty Max, a 5'11 sophomore, number 13, Nancy Kane. For Minooka, a 6-foot junior, number 13, Sammy. And for Mother McAuley, a 5'6 senior, number 14, Emma Riley. The floor officials for this match are Mark Baboni and Janice McGreary. Line judges are Tracy Levine and Keon Lassiter. Barb Maui and Louis Green serve the IHSA as the official coordinator.
Today's championship matchup is brought to you by Country Financial. At Country Financial, we understand that helping you means knowing you. Take charge of owning your future with Country Financial. Call your local rep at 1-866-COUNTRY or visit ownyourfuture.com.
We are back. At Redbird Arena, Doug Collins Court, the 4A state championship. We've seen 1, 2, 3 played out. Now we get to see the big schools, Mother McAuley and Minooka. What an atmosphere in this place. Two biggest crowds we've seen so far this weekend. The Minooka fans are out in full force. No doubt about that. Minooka made up of kids from Minooka, obviously, Shanahan and Shorewood, and then the faithful from Mother McAuley with the big heads. I love big heads. That's the bananas back there, and then there's the band.
And they're cheering, too. That's right. Wonder who they want to win. They're just a neutral band.
Oh, we'll see them throughout the course of the match. They get up and dance quite a bit. All right, we're ready to go. Again, all kinds of Division I players, Division II players, Division III players on the floor. If you're on this floor here tonight, you can play in college, Coach.
Yes, you can. And that's what makes this 4A volleyball championship so fun, is because it is a dominant, high-paced, powerful game.
Oh, Coach Dornbos said, look out for Rocky Perinar, and she will serve. Young lady with an offer. She's accepted it. She's going to play in the Volunteer State for the University of Tennessee next year. And we are underway. 4A state championship. A miscommunication between Baranski and Perinar. And that's that nervousness, I think, right off the bat. Minooka can't come out here nervous. If they do, Mother McAuley will blow their doors off.
Yeah, this is definitely a point for point, and every error is going to add up in this match.
Ashley Mayer will serve for the Max in their red shirts. And Perinar will hit it long. Then maybe some nerves.
Yeah, we've seen that quite a bit today. Those first few points within the championship matches have been teams that you wouldn't expect to have those errors are making.
Pappas will push it over, and that is long. Actually wide. A quick start for the Mighty Max. It's 3-0, and this is not the start Kerry Prosek, the head coach of Minooka, wanted.
Well, it's all got to start with the pass, and right now Mother McAuley's been serving very aggressive, having Minooka out of system, be able to run everything they want.
Pappas with a kill. She's headed to Dayton. She's been their most consistent performer.
That was a great shot by Pappas going down the line. And that's the thing about all these outside hitters. They're obviously going to have some focus on them, but they've got to change up their shots. They can't just go across the whole time or
blind. And Maddie Zeke sends her to serve long. There's Carrie Prosek, the head coach of the Minooka Indians. She played her college volleyball at Charleston Southern. Her husband Mike played at Lewis University. And she's got a lot of family coaching genes. Her uncle Dale won a state championship in softball at Joliet Township. And her dad, Mike O'Connell, a legendary coach in the Joliet area. So if you're an O'Connell, you are coach. Her brother Rory coached up at Lockport in the basketball program, still does. What is it with you coaches and the bloodlines?
We're born with it, I guess.
How about this rally, huh? And Nigo, I believe, touched the net, actually went underneath the net. And that'll be a point for the Indians. There you saw the athleticism on both teams. Seems like Minooka is settling in a little bit now.
Yeah, get those first point jitters out. Just realize, hey, I can dig that ball. Hey, we see this at practice. You know, some of that's just realizing they're just as equal as you.
There's Nigo hitting the ball literally straight down. There's the legendary head coach, Jen DeGerald. 12 years, 418 wins already in Mother McAuley and one state title, but she wants to win her second one. You want to start adding up state titles. They go to the back, and a good run by O'Connell. She hits it into the net.
Well, the back row attack is very effective for all the teams, but if you can have a good outside hitter that's comfortable hitting from the back, it can score you a lot of points.
Nigo will get the point. Bonde not able to send the block back over the net. We see a lot of that young lady tonight, Charlie Nigo. Nancy Kane, the super sophomore setter, sends that one into the net. Nigo not able to get it over the tape, and that's a point for the Indians. And just like that, they are within one.
Well, if you look at the stats right now, Minooka's hitting -167 and Mother McAuley hitting zero. So for being high-powered offenses, we're not seeing a lot of offense right now.
Baranski tried to go cross-court and hit that one just a little wide. Point for the Mighty Max. And here's Nigo to serve. Bondi, great dig. That was Kane. Perinar will try. That is good.
What a great shot by Perinar there. She was lined up to go cross court. She just turned her shoulder and hit that back right back corner. Great shot.
Serving will be Holly Bondi. And she serves into the net. Bondi, Perinar, Clank, and a couple of the other young ladies that maybe don't play as much. They won a state championship as eighth graders, finished second as seventh graders at Shanahan Junior High School. So they got a lot of hardware. They even took home second in basketball. Helps when you have a bunch of 5'9 girls in seventh grade and then eighth grade, 5'11 girls, and they get to high school and they're 6'1 and 6'2.
Well, Minooka so far has had three service errors while Mother McAuley's had one. So I don't know if the draft's affecting them in here or just getting settled in.
There's a block by Pappas. And we're tied at eight. Minooka fell behind 3-0, but they've caught the Mighty Max. This is a Mother McAuley team that this year they've started their big games very slowly. Then around the 15-point mark is where they hit the gas. And that is in a wonderful smash from Katie O'Connell. O'Connell headed to Ferris State. How about this, a 31 on her ACT.
So she's very smart. One shy of a perfect score.
I don't even want to tell you how far away I was from 31.
I think is 32 perfect?
36 is perfect.
Oh, 36 is perfect, excuse me. I must not have been close to perfect either.
Here's Zeke to serve. It's her second serve of the night. The last one sailed out of bounds. This one she keeps in play. And Kane, again, steps way under the net. Will get whistled by the referee, and that'll be a point for Minooka.
Well, and Kane is being aggressive in those. It's just the passes need to be pushed off there.
It's Minooka's first lead of the match. Blocked by Pappas, and that'll be a point for the Indians. And this is what we talked about at the top of the broadcast here, Coach. Don't take this team for granted. And not that Mother McAuley is, but they are talented.
Yeah, every team that's here in the championship has had to win tough games to get here. It's not an easy path, especially in the Chicagoland area.
And if you want to look at some comparisons, all we need to do is look right away to Geneva. Minooka played Geneva in the final regular season game of the year, and they lost in three, and the last set was 25-23. And Geneva and Mother McAuley just played as Nego wins at the net. And Mother McAuley won in three, and the super sectional in the last set was 25-21. So just look in the last 2 weeks at common opponent Geneva and say, yeah, this might be evenly matched here tonight. Pappas soars in and hits it into the middle of the net. O'Connell will serve for the Mighty Max. They've won two of the last 3 points to go up by one. That was way long, but Bondi took it anyway, but Pappas bails her out with a kill. Allie Pappas, number five, she knows what number Charlie Nego's got across from her. She wants to be the best number five on the floor tonight, and if she thinks she is the best number five tonight, the Minooka's got a chance to win. But the McAuley number five comes back with a kill of her own.
Look at the power she has when she hits the ball.
And these girls, the least ones we've highlighted here so far, are all juniors. Here's another junior, Casey McCander for Mother McAuley. Nice dig from Mayer. O'Connell pushes it across. Bachman with the receive. Pappas. Great dig by McCander. Nego has it blocked. That looked like Sammy Herman, another junior.
Well, we can talk about this later on in the game, but every touch that the block gets is 1 point for the defense because it is getting in the hitter's head of each shot that they've taken that's gotten a touch on it.
Cross court they go to Nego. A good dig in the back by Pappas. You see her versatility at 6'1", 6'2". Hard to stop Nego, especially a second time on the same point.
Yeah, she's going to win that battle most times. The hitter is.
Nancy Kane will serve. Mother McAuley up by one. Best two out of three. Class 4A state championship from Redbird Arena here on Comcast Sportsnet. And that's a kill for Mother McAuley. Abby O'Brien, she's headed to Ferris State with her teammate Katie O'Connell. They'll play for the Bulldogs up in Big Rapids.
And both seniors, we talked about how this is mostly junior laden, but both seniors going to the same school, it's special for them.
If you're a coach at Ferris State and you can get not one, but two Mighty Mac players to come, you're gonna take them. Perinar goes long. And we're gonna get a timeout taken by Kerry Prosek, the head coach of Minooka. Midway through the opening set, Mother McAuley's opened up a 3-point lead on Minooka, and you're watching the 4A state championship from Normal on Comcast Sportsnet.
From the gridiron to the hardwood, on the links or on the track, on the diamond or on the ice, go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever. The IHSA is competition, teamwork, integrity,
determination, triumph. The future plays here, the Illinois High School Association.
Welcome back to Redbird Arena. Minooka fans have showed up in big numbers here tonight. If you take a look at those shirts, it says hashtag Smith Strong. They're all wearing them. The players wore them as warm-ups. That is in honor of the late Mark Smith, a 29-year-old teacher at Minooka Community High School who died just a couple of days ago after a brief battle with brain cancer. Mark taught geology at Minooka, coached track and field. His mom is a big-time track and field coach and trainer in the Shanahan Minooka area. His brother's a runner at Nebraska. Real sad story. He leaves behind his wife, Jess, and two daughters, Cora and Livia. So our condolences to the Smith family. And Minooka is all about Smith Strong making it all the way to the state championship game. I hate to hear stories like that, but you love to see schools honor someone. And after Minooka gets a point following the timeout, Mother McAuley gets that point right back, and here's Nego to serve. Baranski on the receive. Great block. That was O'Connell. She'll try for the kill now. Baranski denies her. Perinar. Nego from the back. It's saved by Papish. Great action. Perinar dinks over the top. Cleaned up there by Kane.
Say, both setters have a pretty nice job tonight. Which hitter do they feed?
There's the junior, Bondi. Bondi's headed to Kansas State. She'll be a Wildcat for 4 years. And she is a true 6'3".
That's a nice addition Kansas State's getting.
No exaggeration there. Usually they add an inch or two, but not her. You see the big bodies doing a nice job blocking for Minooka. And speaking of blocking, that is out. Is that McCander? No, that was Amanda Horn. Got her hands on it, but it just missed the sideline. Are we watching a college game tonight or a high school game?
Part of me thinks, yeah, man.
Horn gets a kill, a quick set in the middle. And Amanda buries it. In all seriousness, you don't see this type of blocking at this level. Even this is the highest level in high school volleyball. You don't see this much of it usually.
Well, they're so disciplined. When they're going against the hitter, you can tell they're communicating, they're lining up, and it's just great discipline and attention to detail right now on both sides.
Perinar lights it up.
One thing we haven't seen from either side is their middles being too involved. Everything's going right side, outside. Just says how much power both of these teams have on the pin hitters.
Perinar sure sails long. A couple times she's done that now. Sub coming in for Mother Mac, it's Ashley Mayer, 5'5 senior. She'll serve. The Mighty Macs, what a program. State titles, 14 of them. 3 seconds, 4/3, 1/4. Most decorated program in Illinois history. There's a middle. Papish. Great save by Baranski.
The hustle between these two teams is just amazing to me.
Perinar with a spectacular play. O'Connell finally ends it. That right there encapsulates what these two teams are capable of doing.
Great volley.
Mother McAuley to 20, leads by 3. High, soft serve. Nothing soft about that from Pappas. She's really a high flyer.
Yes, she is. She has a nice, tall reach. She's headed to Dayton University. But she's only a junior as well, so she's got one more year before she can head there.
Serve from Olivia Clank is long. Another service error. Kerry Prosek tries to always keep a smile on her face. But you see that look right there. She's a little frustrated with a lot of the errors her girls are making.
Yeah, just the kind of unanswered errors as far as serving errors that they don't usually make. A long hit tips out.
Pappas got a lot on that. She was about 3 feet behind the 10-foot line and still buried it.
Yeah, it just shows how much power she has, because that is not a comfortable look when you're behind the 10-foot line. You really gotta adjust your feet. And great shot to go back towards that corner, right back.
And McAuley still the 2-point leader, first set. And Nigo will get a kill. Ransky couldn't keep her hands off it.
Well, Nigo comes from a very strong family as well of volleyball. Her mom played at University of Pacific and won a national championship while there.
Well, Nigo's mom also has her number retired, had Mother McAuley. They brought the number out of retirement for Charlie to wear, and her younger sister, who's a freshman at Mother McAuley, will also be able to wear it. Then it goes back into the trophy case. Bombay blocked. And yes, it was Nigo. And Jen DeGerald feeling a lot better now than she did about 4 or 5 minutes ago. Her girls have a 4-point lead, 23-19.
That last block just shows what a momentum carrier that could be. Blocking, I just feel like sometimes blocking doesn't get the attention it needs, because it's the first contact before your diggers can get to it, and it can have such a great impact on your defense.
Talk about the state titles for Mother McAuley. All right, let's run them down while we have a second. 77, 80, 81, 82. They finished a distant second in 83. State championships in 84, 85, 87, 92, 94. 95, 97, 2000, 2004, 2013. Third place, or three second place finishes in 83, 96, and 07. Four third place finishes in 90, 05, 08, and 12. And a fourth place finish in 91. 14 state titles in all, and 22 trophies. You need a wing, not a trophy case, a wing to handle all that hardware.
And that's just for state championships. That's not including your tournaments and your regional right. plaques and your sectional plaques.
Pappas wide, and Mother McAuley has set points. 24-19. Dig from Perinar, but it's out of bounds. And the Mighty Max, we told you, their best volleyball comes midway through a game and towards the end of it, and we saw that there.
You're absolutely right, and it's amazing to watch. It's just like a machine. As soon as they hit point 17, there was no looking back for the Mighty Max.
The Mighty Max, 25, Minooka 19, set one in the books. You're watching the 4A State Championship from Redbird Arena on Comcast SportsNet.
From the gridiron to the hardwood, on the links or on the track, on the diamond or on the ice. Go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever.
If that student body looks like it's all girls, that's because Mother McAuley has no boys in their school. It's an all-girls school. So, yes, you're probably wondering, where are all the guys tonight? Well, not there, because that's where the students from Mother McAuley sit. We're back here at Redbird Arena. Jen DeGerald was an incredible athlete, played at Iowa, won two state titles as a player in 84 and 85. And of course, there's been some legendary coaches at Mother McAuley. It all started with Donna Smith back in 1977 in the first state title, and Marianne Malone, then Nancy Peterson, and Minooka starting a tradition of their own. What a last couple of years it's been for Minooka. Check this out. School didn't win any state championships until the wrestling team did it in 2010. Then they won a girls softball state championship in 2013. Girls cross country last year, and the girls finished third this year. And they had the individual boys state champion, young man by the name of Soren Knudsen, whose dad also won the state championship in 1981. First time in Illinois history a father-son has won a state cross-country championship. Wow. They both hail from Minooka.
A lot of tradition between these two schools.
Yeah. All right, we're set to go. All right, keys for the Indians here. They can't fall behind again like they did last match.
No, they have to have better passing, more aggressive serving, and they have to find a way to contain. That's one way to start off.
That's, you watch something like that and you say, junior in high school? Are you kidding me? We say the same thing about Nigo, Bondi, Perinar. Girls are getting better at a younger age now. Good dig by Bondi. That was blocked up front nicely. That was Bolin.
Great coverage defense here by Minooka, getting blocked twice, but coming back in their coverage, staying in the game.
There's Perinar. Back row for Rocky. What a play by Nigo. And that'll be long. You know, at this level, usually 6-footers, 6'1", girls, 6'2", aren't real good in the back. Sometimes they even rotate out. But the 6-footers here tonight are making incredible digs on the back row.
They are, and you know, that just talks about how great of an all-around player they are, because it seems as if the taller girls, as you say, are getting more athletic and more used to and more demanded in the back row six rotations.
And how about this start for Minooka? A 3-0 lead. Maddie Zeke serving and serving well. Bachman sends it across to Pappish. Great effort by Nigo, but to no avail.
Now Dayton University recruit Pappish, it's nice to see her get going so quickly in this game. We've kind of been waiting to see her get on a roll.
Good set by Kane on a tough pass. Ooh. Pappish hit the pin. Baranski back in as the serve is set from Katie O'Connell. It's a Mother McAuley team as O'Connell serves along that lost one match all year, folks. They're 39-1. They lost to St. Joe's Academy out of St. Louis. They finished fifth in the tournament back in September down in Louisville. And the girls got home, they said, you know, we really don't like fifth place, so let's not do that again. And they haven't. And a point for the Mighty Max. Another interesting thing, you know, this Mother McAuley team is ranked number one in the nation, number one team in the nation, according to some polls. They got that honor on the 14th of October, and Coach DeGerald didn't say anything to her girls didn't say anything, and they acted like it didn't even happen because, according to Coach DeGerald, she said it really didn't matter to the girls. This here is what matters, what's happening tonight.
Talk about some seriously committed athletes and not letting that go to their head because it could be so easily
Absolutely.
Done.
Well, that all starts with her right there. And she's been there. She's played. Don't get caught up in the moment. Look at the big prize. A nice quick hit in the middle. That's the second time today that Amanda Horn has taken care of business from that middle position.
Well, it's nice to see the Max using their middle. So far in the game, it's been most of the outside, so it's nice to see the Max start getting in system a little bit more, and that comes from good passing.
Here's the future Division I player, Nancy Kane, 5'11" sophomore, setter, and there's Nigo.
Those are so fun. They come over the net, they go straight down as long as you touch them, right?
Kane will serve again. McAuley within two. And that ball is in. Baranski let it go. She thought it was going to sail outside.
Well, this is an important point for Minooka here. They really need a good pass to be able to set it out to, let's see, Perenar's out there, Rocky's out there.
Yep. Baranski, Bachman to Perenar. Back set to Bonde, and that's a kill. Bachman gets the assist. Bachman, an interesting story, the setter for Minooka. She started playing volleyball, does not play club volleyball at all. You say, wait a minute, there's no way she can be a setter on maybe a state championship team. She's a basketball player and a pole vaulter.
A pole vaulter?
Pole vaulter, yes.
Wow. She's 5'6"?
Nigo.
Nice.
Yep, a very good pole vaulter and a four-year starter on the basketball team for the Minooka Indians, and Ray Libertor, the head coach. Rarely do you see two sport athletes with girls volleyball players that play at this level. They just don't do it. That ball is outside. Minooka extends the lead now to 8-6. You know, girls specialize now, and it's good to see Bachman, who you see right there in the middle of your screen, not just two sports, but three.
Yeah, that is really encouraging to see that there are
players. See there by Nigo. What's interesting too, Bachman is getting recruited by some Division II basketball schools, but now she may want to play volleyball. She's like, this is fun.
Yeah, absolutely, especially when you get to set all these hitters out here, Division I hitters.
Yeah. Perenar, right through the hands of Nancy Kane. And timeout by Mother McAuley. As Minooka has a four-point lead, the Mighty Max lead, 1-0. But the Indians are fighting back. And this is the 4A state championship from Redbird Arena on Comcast SportsNet.
Country Financial wants to know, do you feel in control of your financial future?
No, sort of. But I have the desire to be in control of my money.
I need a plan.
At Country Financial, our goal is to work with you to lay out a step-by-step plan of insurance and financial solutions to help you regain control of your financial planning, to help you own your future.
Understanding is empowering.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
Back here at Redbird Arena, the 4A state championship game. A timeout taken by Jen DeGerald, the head coach of Mother McAuley. 4-point advantage for the Indians. Good dig by Baranski. Great dig by Nigo. And O'Connell puts it away. Katie O'Connell will join Abby O'Brien at Ferris State. Emily Riley's going to Appalachian State. Ashley Maher, the defensive specialist, she's going to Lipscomb. And Nigo's headed to Notre Dame. And that's an ace. Back-to-back points by Mother McAuley following the timeout.
So just going off of what you said, that is six Division I players on one side of the court.
Set, and that's long for Nigo. You know, watching Nigo play defense, she's remarkable back there. Hate to say that's her best position, but it might be.
Well, sometimes the best hitters are the best defensive players because they know what a hitter's looking for and how to align their body and just have a really good read at the ball.
She makes it look so easy. Good dig by Bondi there. Now Papish is back on the left for Minooka. Bachman to Papish. Really nothing Emma Riley could do about that.
Great swing by Papish there, going cross court, picking on those corners.
Minooka back up by four. It's 12-8. Kane, a real nice bump serve to O'Connell. Oh. That's out. Point for the Mighty Max.
Well, if you're Minooka, this is the time where you really need to rush to that 15, get to the 15 points, and then work on the next five. Don't get caught up so much on Mother McAuley's each point that they're getting.
That's a good place to start. This time, the middle of the floor to Pappas. Herman checks back in. And serving will be Maddie Zeke. Good block in the middle. Herman and Pappish. Bachman's set was a little off, and Pappish ran into the net.
We were talking about defense earlier. Rocky Perinar had some great digs in that rally, too. And, you know, some of that is just the length that they have in the back row. You know, if you're 6'2", you can reach out. You're going to cover more area than 5'4".
Wonderfully placed by Pappas. That'll bring a smile to her face. Great job of finding that corner. Look at some individual stats. Pappas with 10 kills already to lead everyone. Nigo has 9. Great dig by Baranski. Pappas with another kill. Number 11.
Taylor Baranski all over the court on that. She dug a ball, and the next ball she's setting after it's been touched by someone else, and then she's back there for coverage. Great libero.
Well, you said get to 15 and worry about the next five. Minooka's at 15. Baranski, perfect set, and a block. Bonde stuffed by Nigo.
Great penetration on that ball. We have a pretty good view from here, and her hands were straight over that net. There was no way that ball was going through.
Serving for the Mighty Max now, it's Casey McCander, 5'9 junior. Pappas digs her over the top. Sent a double block at her. She saw it.
Well, in a game like this, when it is so high-powered from your hitters, that is a great shot to use that tip to your advantage.
And now she'll serve. Miscommunication between Baranski and Bachman.
Well, in this case, that miscommunication brought Mother McAuley within 3 points, Did they get that point right? Within four. I thought it went to three, but within four.
But it's certainly within arm's length. Great dig in the back from O'Connell. First you don't succeed, try again.
She is such a fun player to watch.
Nigo in double figures now with 11 kills. And here is Nancy Kane. Bonde is blocked. Baranski, a spectacular save. And Perinar finishes off the point.
Baranski coming back through for Minooka again on those digs.
Carrie Prosek, the head coach, she's played a lot of volleyball over the years. She's got a chance to win the state championship tonight, and it would be improbable. Minooka is to 18, and Jen DeGerald takes her second time out of the second set.
Well, it's definitely a regrouping, because this is about the time where you mentioned where Mother McAuley can creep back and just put that full throttle in. But they haven't been able to do that because their passing hasn't allowed them to feed the ball the way they want to.
So So there are the Indians from Minooka. They play in the Southwest Prairie Conference with Plainfield schools, Oswego schools, the Joliet schools moved into their conference, West and Central, for the first time this year. Plainfield East, North, Central, South. Used to be members of the Little Seven Conference when the school was small and it was an agricultural town, but now it's a big school with over 2,600 students.
That's bigger than the town I live in.
And there are the faithful with those Smith Strong shirts. ...18-13, the Indians on top of the Mighty Max. And Baranski will serve. And there's a kill for the Mighty Max.
And that's exactly what Jen DeGard wanted from her team right there after that timeout.
Abby O'Brien, 5'9 senior. All these six-footers out here, she said, I can still play. Good block in the middle. That was Amanda Horn on the block from Perrinart. And another kill. Back-to-back kills for Abby O'Brien.
Well, this is where it's going to start getting interesting. This is where Mother McAuley is known to come back and start leading the way and get a run on points. It's going to be Manuka's job here to stop him with this serve.
Nego to serve. Outside to Bonde. Connell is blocked. Perrinart digs it over the top.
Well, that's twice now. Perrinart's found that hole open behind the block. So Mother McAuley either needs to make some adjustments or do something to make Perrinart hit the ball.
Bondi will serve. O'Brien. A huge, huge dink over the top. That's her third point here in the last four. Two kills and a little roll over the block. Nuka's lead was five, it's now three. And Perrinart makes it four. Well, she's come to life.
She's heading to the back row.
Brian blocked this time by Clank. Blocked again. Point for Minooka. Clank and Pappas.
4 points to go for the first set here.
How about Clank? A middle hitter at 5'9".
Middle hitter at 5'9". That you don't see on stats very often. Having the success she's had.
O'Connell, nicely done. Katie O'Connell is so good. On most other teams, she'd be the best player, but when you're playing with Charlie Nego, you have to kind of tip your cap, but Katie O'Connell is special also. Ashley Mayer to serve, high soft serve. Pappas with yet another kill. Let's take a look at some of the kill percentages here, Coach.
Well, for game two, Minooka has been hitting 216 and Mother McAuley hitting 122. So you can see that Manuka's had a little bit better offense and success against Mother McAuley.
Maddie Zeke sends it across for the Indians. Pappas again off a perfect feed from the basketball player Bachman.
Well, it helps for Minooka when Rocky Perrinart goes back row. Allie Pappas is front row.
Minooka up six. Great dig from Zeke. Back set and the slide. There's Bolin. Pappas has it blocked by Bolin. Great coverage from Zeke. Point for the Mighty Max. about the fourth or fifth point that you can put on a highlight reel and send it off to the big networks tonight.
Great rally, and to have the setter in that rally just like that, sneaking that in there.
Minooka still with a rather comfortable 5-point advantage. Good cover there by Riley. And we're going to get a double hit from Pappas.
Well, this is interesting right here because Mother McAuley has the capability to come back and tie this up. And that's the thing about Minooka. You've got to realize you have the advantage. You have to finish on it.
Pappas was blocked, but the ball's out of bounds. It was blocked by Nancy Kane. That'll be a point for the Indians, and they have set point to try to even up this match. Bachman to serve. Eagle blocked by Bombay. And the young Minooka Indians have forced a third and decisive set. Well, next year was supposed to be their year, but like the Cubs last year, they made it to the championship game before losing. So maybe a year early for this team. We'll have to wait and see. We have a third and final set coming up next from Redbird Arena on Comcast SportsNet. The Mighty Max and the Indians are going to a decisive third set.
The IHSA is motivation. Effort. Innovation. Emotion. Community. The future plays here, the Illinois High School Association.
The Minooka Indians have tied this match up, the state championship match, and as they break into the huddle with head coach Kerry Prosek, they walk off with a lot of confidence out onto the court here at Redbird Arena. Mother McAuley and Jen DeGerald, that second set was a wake-up call, huh?
It was, absolutely. And, you know, Minooka's coming out with their heads high, and it's a resetting time for Mother McAuley. Come out, reset, 0-0, and now you got to leave everything out there.
Now the fans are dying to know what's going to happen. It's like watching one of those shows that you spend like a whole season watching and you want to fast forward to the end just to see what happens, right?
Or if you're a Cubs fan, you just want the 10th inning to be over with and find out, right?
Just tell me who wins. Well, these girls have all played so much club volleyball, such big games, national championship games, that they're used to big games. But this, still playing for your high school and playing for your hometown, is still the best.
It is.
Pappas will try to get him off on the right foot, and she does just that.
And I believe Pappas started off the second set.
She did.
The exact same point, the exact same way.
And she's starting to rack up the numbers with 16 kills now in a state championship. McConnell goes cross court, Zeke with the dig. Nigo into the net. And you're seeing these young Indians start to play with a lot of confidence.
You are. That's a rare error by Nigo to see that.
Quick set by Kane. The ball was hit into the net by Bolin.
Well, we were talking during the break. We haven't seen much involvement with the middle, so it's nice to see Mother McAuley relying a little bit there on their middle.
Well, you're right, these teams are both so strong on the outside. Well, check that. That was a point for Mother McAuley. It's my mistake. And then another violation against the Indians, and just like that, it's 2-2. Perenaar receiving air. See if her teammates can bail her out here. Pappas misfires.
I expect this will be the way the entire time to point 25.
Three consecutive points for Mother McAuley. And O'Connell always seems to be in the thick of things when Mother McAuley's making a run. There you go, great dig by Baranski. Here's Papish. Great effort by Maher. And another kill. This time it's Nego, number 12 on the night for her.
Well, if the hitting's not enough for you, just watch the defensive specialists in this match and the fact that they're digging those balls and they're just the effort. It's just amazing.
Four consecutive points until that service error from O'Connell for Mother McAuley. And here's Bachman. Serving 3-4. Nice play up front by Kane.
And a setter is most successful in those moments when they have big outsides and big middles that everybody's paying attention to, and a setter just gets forgotten about. If a setter's dumping all the time, it doesn't work. In her case, great execution there.
Here's Casey McCander serving for Mother McAuley. They lead by two. Bonde has it blocked. That's out of bounds. Nice work over on the far side from Amanda Horn. But the Indians get the point. Here's Papish serving. Matters out, and we're tied at five.
Well, it'll be a game of five for this set three. First to 10 now.
Bachman with a set. Perinar hits it into the net. If you're just tuning in, Mother McAuley won the first set 25-19. Minooka won the second 25-19. And here we are in the deciding third and final set with Mother McAuley leading 6-5. And that is out. Good judgment from Papish back there. That was awfully close. See her kind of breathe a sigh of relief. Taylor Baranski, whose mom runs the Uno Volleyball Club. Bonde tried to dink it over the top, comes up short. 7-6, Mother McAuley. This is shaping up as a classic championship game.
I like it, don't you?
Just catch myself watching these girls.
Yeah.
Bachman to Clank. And Clank was in the net.
Number 12, Amanda Horn, was making sure that the up ref knew that she was in the net. I think she was a little worried there that that was going to get by.
Nego with a serve. And that's long. Carrie Prosek's going to take a timeout. I was just going to say she just might need one because Mother McAuley has scored three consecutive points and they lead by three.
Yeah, and against other teams other than Mother McAuley, you might get away with a couple of points getting by, but in the state championship, the team of Mother McAuley's caliber, it's best just to take a timeout to reset.
Well, we all knew about Mother McAuley, number one team of the nation, 38-1. Like the rest of the state, if they didn't know, maybe the fringe fan or casual fan didn't know much about Minooka, they do now.
They do, yes, and they have proven that they earned their way here. Great dominant outside hitters, their libero, Taylor Baranski. She's had amazing digs tonight, considering who she's going up against on the other side of the net.
Absolutely. They only have six losses, twice to Geneva, once to Plainfield Central, once to Munster, Indiana, lost to Marist, and also lost to Normal University. And that's it. Mother McAuley, of course, their lone loss was to a team from St. Louis down in Louisville. And there's a service error. Minooka stems the tide for the time being.
And Minooka ended up playing Normal Community again for the Super Sectional Championship, and that was a very close one, 27-25, 26-24.
O'Connell just inside the stripe. Good Southside Irish girl, O'Connell, right? With the red hair. Well, that was just a special hit by Perenard. The set was behind her about at the 10-foot line, and she still got it down.
Just shows her athleticism and great awareness of what's available to hit in those instances.
Now Perenard will serve. Down two. So Bryan, who's had a big night so far. Good block up top there by Boland. Oranski almost was able to come up with a point for the Mighty Max.
Well, and you're sitting here watching and you see some of these service errors or you see some of these hitting errors, and it's hard to remember that these are sophomores, juniors, some are seniors, but they're still high school.
Yes.
And you just get caught up in the moment of just how great these two teams are.
Pappish with another kill. Nego not able to catch up with that. That's the 18th kill for Allie Pappish. She said she respects the other number five so much on Mother McAuley, Charlie Nego. She said, I want to be the best number five on the floor tonight. And she has played very well. That is out. That was touched, though, by Minooka. Point for Mother McAuley. Give the kill to Mary Kay Poland. There's one of your middles.
Yeah, middle, give the kill.
I take it you played middle.
No, I played middle in high school. I was a left side in college, though.
Pappish again.
But I like watching the middles because it really does take a very athletic, versatile person to play that position.
Mother McAuley up to Bachman to serve. Baranski sets Bondi. And that is another kill from the middle. And that's Boland once again. That's two here in this third set. She'll sit down, and coming into serve will be Casey McCander.
Well, if you're Minooka here, this point is very important to you. You really just want to set this out to make it more of a two-point game rather than a three, or four, excuse me.
Bondi will get the kill. Actually, no, they won't. They said she was in the net. Serve was a little, just a touch off. McCander will serve again. Mother McAuley up four. Crucial point here for Minooka. Aaron, a great dig by O'Connell. That's out. One official said in, the other said out, but it did look like it was out.
Yeah, and that official is calling the line. From where she's standing, it was in, but from the official on the other end line that has the best view, they're gonna go with him.
Mother McAuley all of a sudden has opened up a 5-point cushion. And in this match, that is a sizable lead. Pappish. O'Connell digs her kill attempt. Nego. Miscommunication between Bachman and Herman. But you can't blame either one of them. They're just playing hard. And another timeout taken by the Indians as Mother McAuley starting to smell its 15th state championship. You're watching the 4A state title game from Redbird Arena on Comcast SportsNet.
Country Financial wants to know, what do you look for in a financial services partner?
Get to know us and get to know what we need and what we want to do.
Treat me like they would treat their family.
Help us decide what is a want and what is a need.
I want something tailor-made for me.
At Country Financial, our goal is to take the time to get to know you and then help you put together a customized package of insurance and financial solutions to help you own your future.
When someone really listens and they're planning for us, I trust them.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
The IHSA is sportsmanship, competition, pageantry, strength, respect. The future plays here, the Illinois High School Association.
Katie O'Connell with 7 kills tonight. The young lady headed to Ferris State. She has been big defensively, her passing. She's done it all right tonight. That ball went outside the pin. And again, it was a service receive mistake.
Yeah, that puts a lot of pressure on your outside to keep that ball in play. And so far for Minooka, we've just seen too many small errors, and they've really added up in this set.
Is it the lack of experience in this kind of game?
I don't know if it's that or just, it very well could be.
Great dig by Baranski. That ball is out. And the Mighty Macs are cruising now. 8-point lead.
Well, they've brought Papish to the right side. Hopefully, or hoping that the Mighty Macs haven't noticed. Watch for her to get the ball.
Hoffman goes back set. The Papish too long, out of bounds. The lead is 9 for Mother McAuley.
Papish looks a little flustered right now, just frustrated at that, but the set wasn't the greatest. It was behind the pin, and that just puts a lot of pressure on your outside to try and keep that ball in play.
Kate Barker enters at the middle position for the first time here tonight. That serve is out of bounds. Service there for Casey McCander. Allie Papish, 6'1 junior, will serve. Nego had a block by Bondi. So bump set it over to Paradar. How about that? The set from the 6'3" Bondi.
Paradar's happy with that swing. She could smell the blood on that one. She was taking that slide approach into that ball. It was a nice inside set.
How about Rocky Paradar's family? She's got volleyball in her blood. We'll get to it after this point. Paradar tried to go deep, but it was tracked down by Riley. And O'Connell gets another kill. Talking about Paradar, her sister Stacy played at Eastern Michigan. Her sister Brenna currently plays at the University of St. Francis. Her brother Mitch plays at Lewis University. And her other sister Ginger plays at Southern Illinois Carbondale and is a department store model.
Wow.
How about that for a family? And she's going to Tennessee. That's a lot of free college education.
And some great athletes.
And Paradar, she knew we were talking about her. She gets another kill. That's her 11th. Yeah, add up all that scholarship though, huh?
Yeah.
Baranski will serve. Minooka down 7. Mother McAuley is like a machine. They just keep coming at you. Kane with a nice dig. Bondi gets the block. Clank was in the vicinity as well. And a timeout taken by Jen DeGerald as the lead has been trimmed to 6. But when you watch Mother McAuley, yeah, Nego's fancy, but they're just a workmanlike team. They just scratch and they claw. I saw them in practice on Thursday. And I watched them and I said, oh, they're really good. And then you see some of these other girls come in and they go 6'3", 6'2". There's a girl in Illinois volleyball that's 6'8", for crying out loud. But they just play so well as a team, and it's the system that's in place.
It is, and every player out there on the court and on the bench knows their role. And if they stay within their role, everything goes just fine. And you see that, they just, like you said, point by point. They know exactly what they're supposed to do.
And they're 5 points away from their 15th state championship. Baranski to serve for Minooka. Great effort. Unbelievable hustle. And it's cleared. Are you kidding me? Nego gets the kill. How about the play from Emma Riley and then Charlie Nego?
Amazing. And such composure among the team. They weren't frantic or anything. They just kept on going.
Minooka had a chance to cut it to five. Instead, it's at seven. Bondi with a gunshot. Nancy Kane not able to keep that in play. Much needed point for the Indians. They're within six, and Bondi will serve.
While defending the serve here, and against Mother McAuley, that can be very difficult to do.
O'Connell, and that'll be another kill.
And that's why. Great swing by McAuley.
Katie O'Connell says, hey, all you D1ers out there, I'm going D2, and I'm happy about it, and I can play also. And she certainly can. And the serve from Riley into the net. 22-15, Mother McAuley 3 points away. Make that 22-16. Now it's Perenar. O'Connell again. What else can you say about that young lady that hasn't already been said? Bachman to Papish. And O'Reilly with the dig. That is in. Just hit the line. Zeke back in the game to serve for Minooka. 23-17. The Indians need a run here. Bachman to Papish. And Nego there.
Yeah,
Maher almost didn't go after it.
Yeah.
Another kill for Rocky Perenar. That's her 12th.
Great swing by Perenar. Keeping the ball alive here.
23-18. O'Connell. What a save from Bondi. But still, the point for the Mighty Max. And they're 1 point away from the state championship. And rightly so, Katie O'Connell will try to finish it off. Papish. Papish with her 20th kill.
I think it was.
To say, have we ever had a losing team get the MVP award for a game? We might tonight. Still match point, championship point. And there it is. And the celebration is on. And rightly so, their all-stater Charlie Nego with the finishing kill. Fifteen's a nice round number, isn't it?
It is. And what an accomplishment for such a great school to have 15 state championships.
And look at the scores for all three games. 25-19, 19-25, 25-19. Well, what a match.
Yeah, compliments to Minooka. They made it three sets in a great game.
And yes, maybe a year early for the Indians. I have a feeling they'll be back here next year. Mudda McAuley celebrating number 15 here at Redbird Arena. And you're watching the 4A State Championship on Comcast Sportsnet.
Country Financial wants to know, do you feel in control of your financial future?
No, sort of. But I have the desire to be in control of my money.
I need a plan.
At Country Financial, our goal is to work with you to lay out a step-by-step plan of insurance and financial solutions to help you regain control of your financial planning, to help you own your future.
Understanding is empowering.
Visit ownyourfuture.com to find a local Country Financial representative today.
From the gridiron to the hardwood, on the links or on the track,
ball is fumbled, scooped up by Zach Dahl.
On the diamond or on the ice, go to prepfilms.com. It's easy. You can order your DVD online. At prepfilms.com, you make the memories. We'll make them last forever.
Today's championship matchup is brought to you by Country Financial. At Country Financial, we understand that helping you means knowing you. Take charge of owning your future with Country Financial. Call your local rep at 1-866-COUNTRY or visit ownyourfuture.com.
Yes, the party is on for the Mighty Max from Mudda McAuley, another state championship. And that's going to be a fun bus ride home to the south side for sure. A lot of trophies, a lot of medals to be handed out. Let's send it over to the public address announcer for our trophy presentation.
At this time, please meet the Indians of Minooka High School. They finished the 2016 season in second place with a final record of 35 wins and 7 losses. First, meet the superintendent of Minooka High School, Mr. Kenneth Lee. Principal Ronald Kieswetter. Athletic Director Robert Tyrell. And trainer Randy Highball. Now let's meet the coaching staff. Head coach Kerry Prosek. Her assistants, Emily Soto. Christopher Lincoln. Nicole Diamond. And Elizabeth Sherrick. Now, let's meet the team. Number one, Isabella Daly. Number two, Taylor Baranski. Number three, Brooklyn Bachman. Number four, Maddie Zeke. Number five, Ellie Pepish. Number six, McKenna Jacoby. Number seven, Riley Ritchie. Number eight, Rocky Perinar. Number nine, Olivia Clank. Number 10, Kate Barker. Number 11, Holly Bundy. Number 12, Katie Bulger. Number 13, Sammy Herman. Number 14, Cameron Johnson. And number 16, Stacy Tyrell. The manager, Bella Alessio. And Nicole Kajowski. Now let's have Coach Kiri Prosek and the captains of Minooka High School step forward to receive the second place trophy. And now let's meet the Mighty Macs of Chicago, Mother McAuley. Finished the 2016 season in first place with a final record of 40 wins and only one loss. First, let's meet the president of Mother McAuley High School, Mary Klingenberger. Principal Eileen O'Reilly. Athletic Director Lori Jakubaszak. The Assistant Athletic Director Ashley Clanton. Now let's meet the coaches. Head Coach Jen DeJold. Her Assistant Coaches Megan Gardner. Erica Cahill and Kristen Carmody. And now let's meet the players. Number one, Maddie Diedrich. Number two, Ashley Marr. Number five, Charlie Nego. Number six, Abby O'Brien. Number seven, Paige Pappas. Number eight, Katie O'Connell. Number nine, Evie Gorman. Number 10, Mary Kate Bolin. Number 11, Bridget Burke. Number 12, Amanda Horn. Number 13, Nancy Kane. Number 14, Emma Riley. Number 15, Nora Burke. Number 16, Casey McCander. Number 17, Maura Mixon. And number 18, Becca Stepanek. Manager, Caitlin Zintak. And Kayla Telkis. And now, will Coach Jen Gerald and the captains of Mother McAuley please step forward to receive the first place trophy? Ladies and gentlemen, your 2016 Class 4A IHSA State Champions!
We're back here at Redbird Arena. Time now to hear from
back here at Redbird Arena. It's been an incredible weekend. 1A, 2A, 3A,
and also the this country match here.
This will go down as one of the
and this isn't just your second championship, but the school's 15th school championship. Did you set that as a goal this year?
Well, every year we set a goal to win a state championship, and so every year we think we can win one. This year was no different, so we're thrilled to add a 15th to our collection, and I'm honored to be a part of it.
So you guys won the first set. Second set, Minooka won. What was the difference going into that third set?
Well, we started off the second game with a lot of unforced errors on our part, a lot of missed serves, a lot of balls hit out of bounds, and, you know, I just told me we have to play hard, we have to play smart, and we have to play clean volleyball, and I just think we eliminated our errors. We adjusted our defense a little bit, made a couple changes with our blocking.
Well, you definitely have a high-powered offense, and one of those players is Charlie Nego, and you had, I believe, a match high of 19 kills tonight. What was the difference between set two and set three for you?
Yeah, you know, Mike, I think definitely I had to build confidence as the game went on, and I had to keep swinging hard and not taking anything off the ball. So going into the third game, I knew this is the third game, we have to win it. So that was my mentality.
And what's this championship mean to you all as the 15th, but also the second?
Yeah, it means a lot. I was here in eighth grade when they won it in 2013, and it's definitely a dream come true. And I hope to be here back here next year.
Well, best of luck and congratulations, both of you.
Thank you very much.
All right, Scott, back to you.
Thank you, Laura, and congratulations to Coach DeGerald once again. An incredible night of volleyball, no question about it. Mother McAuley takes out Minooka to win its 15th state championship. But you got to look at some of the great individual performances. Of course, we just heard just a couple of minutes ago from Charlie Nego, but how about Katie O'Connell with 11 kills and 13 digs in the back row? And for Minooka, who'll ever forget Ali Papish's performance? 20 kills. Rocky Perinar finished with 12. Brooklyn Bachman had 31 assists. And yeah, Nancy Kane, the sophomore setter for Mother McAuley, also with 31 assists. Oh yeah, and Charlie Nego also with 15 defensive digs. And Coach Dornbos has made her way back to our broadcast location. Those are big numbers for such a big match.
Absolutely, and what a great match. Fun, powerful match, and definitely go down as a great team for Mother McAuley.
No doubt, number 15 for Mother McAuley. Congratulations to the Mighty Macs, the queens of volleyball in the state of Illinois. 25-19, 19-25, 25-19, 4A state championship win over Minooka. For our entire broadcast crew and for Coach Laura Dornbos, I'm Scott Slocum saying so long from Redbird Arena. And thank you for watching IHSA Volleyball on Comcast SportsNet.